Hey guys, how's it going? Gonna be machining this camshaft here for that 11 horsepower Briggs and Stratton. Got it all set up here, indicated. I got the bushings pressed on, and I'm using the bushing material on this end as my holding fixture. Because on a job like this, you want to make sure both of these journals are turning concentric and parallel with one another. Instead of trying to cut one at a time, it'll be going like this. You know what I mean? Little trick I want to show you here, being that the gear's a little big on this Harbor Freight mini lathe, I had to take this part off for now so I can slip it past the gear. Yeah, we're going to machine this journal first. Going to be about, I don't know, $499 to $500,000. Okay. Yep, and it's been a while since I did some videos. And it's been kind of rough. Weather and being sick or food poisoning. Sure what it was. It was pretty nasty stuff. It's funny, it always happens around this time of year, you know. So, not just me, other people. Yep. So, yeah, can't wait till springtime. Weather's not too fun. Okay, tool set up. Yep. Set this back just a little bit. This is all Harbor Freight stuff I got on here. Yeah, it works for what I do. Yeah, it's good. Make sure we got the right clearance. Okay, let's see, make sure we got enough. Yep. Yeah, sometimes this stuff ain't real easy to do the way I'm doing it. Okay, here we go. We got it. Let's make sure we got the clearance. Perfect. Okay. Just turn it kind of probably about as slow as I'm going to turn it. Okay. Two. Yeah, this lathe here is pretty good. Does hold tolerance pretty good. Trying to do something here, it's kind of pretty tough for this machine, I guess. Try to get it as perfect as I can. I have to polish this journal up. Yep. Bushing material was basically a fitting. It was not too easy to machine. So, I'm only taking about 2 thou at a time. Check it after this, see where we're at. Okay, I'm going to try to aim for about 500. Got about 530, it says. Take that much. Might be a little bit long video, but some of this. Cotton lube, pretty good stuff. Cut much better now. There we go. Okay. See where we're at. Ooh, 19 thou way. A little lathe like this, I just take her slow. Job like this, I do about 2 thou cuts. Sometimes 5, but on this, I'm afraid it's going to move on me. About 12. Make sure this is holding good. Yeah, I'd put a good bit of thought into doing this. Get it. I said do like, try to bore a cylinder on camera with that one tool that I got. Starting to get like Mad Max, it seems like, you know. You gotta learn how to fix stuff yourself. Well, the stuff's closing, so. Machine shops, it worked at 8 thou. Make sure this is good, holding. Yeah. 8 thousandths away. Probably set it to 501 and I'll probably just polish that in. Probably a good idea. Six, double check these mics. Yep, it's good. The thing I didn't like about these Brown and Sharp mics, they always were finicky. Got a set of Filer 1-2 bikes. Hell, things are awesome. They never go out. Hell, they ain't need calibrated since I had them. I got them off a guy. They stay right in all the time. Right in there.
Okay. Let's see.
Polishing her up a little. Got that diameter done. Okay, that's good. About $4.99 where you want it. 500 was a little bit too big. Okay, do another. Yep, not where I wanted it. Hey guys, video's getting a little long, so hey guys, the next time keep feeling the heat.